Now, there's another battle in regional Australia over Labor's obsession with renewables. This time it's near Tamworth in northeast New South Wales, with plans to clear private land to make way for 75-metre-tall transmission pylons connecting renewables projects to the grid.
We're absolutely angry. We're frustrated, we're disappointed, and we're, quite frankly, we're quite heartbroken because this is our home.
Now, concerned residents commissioned a report finding the project's going to have significant impact on koala habitat. They've taken up the issue with the New South Wales Environment Minister, Penny Sharp, who doesn't mind cuddling koalas, but she's dismissed the concerns. I caught up with local farmer and campaigner Tim White.
It is, Chris. I mean, it's just more. It adds to the argument. It's not a new argument. We've always had koalas. We've only just managed to get the reports commissioned. It takes a long time and to get these things done, and there's not a lot of time or money to do these things, but we've put all banded together. Our group, Valley Alliance, has got 270 members, and we've all kicked in to get these reports commissioned. And it's come up with what we already knew was there, which, you know, we've come up with at least 34 koalas, and there'll be a lot more because we haven't canvassed nearly the whole area.
Well, this is the astounding thing about the renewables rollout, is the environmental impact it has. We know there's a lot of focus on the East Coast about dwindling koala numbers, yet they're suggesting clearing a pathway through here of 140 metres wide. It seems an extraordinarily wide amount of bush to knock over for a transmission corridor.
It's amazing, mate. I mean, it is 140 metres. They've given us a path right now of 1 kilometre, which they're going to narrow down to 140 metres at some stage. So we'd have no idea really where it's going to go. We've got a 1 kilometre wide band. That 140 metres is going to be fully bulldozed. These towers are 75 metres tall. That's a 25-storey building. They're 450 metres apart, and there's two of them. They're dual power lines. So it's huge. It's a super highway for electricity.
Well, if anybody out there knows anything about koala conservation, they know the number one problem is habitat. You can't go around knocking over all the koala habitat without impacting the koalas. And that's what amazes me with this, is because this is private land, and normally farmers are prevented, understandably, through all sorts of rules and legislation, from clearing their land if they want to put in more crops or run more livestock. Yet here you've got governments okaying a power company coming in and bulldozing native forest.
Rules for some and rules for others, Chris. I mean, this is a joke. We have the amount of red tape we have to jump through to knock down anything, not necessarily trees, but even old structures, is a joke. Now, these guys can come through without any real with no consultation whatsoever, and bulldoze our country. And this is just, it's not even because they can do it, but there is better routes available. I mean, we've suggested that they come and do it elsewhere on public land because it is for the public good. And right now, they've ignored us.
It's just a shocker. Now, interestingly, of course, we know there's a bunch of environmental groups around the place who will arc up any time there's a suggestion that trees and bushland is going to be ruined for a mine or a freeway or other projects. Are any of those groups helping you out in this case, or do they all fall silent when it's connected to renewable energy?
It'll be interesting to see, Chris. I mean, we've only just had these reports released, so we'll find out who comes to our aid at this stage, but at this stage it's radio silence. But I would think that the Greens and the Environmental Defenders Office and the like should come and fight this battle for us, or with us.
Yeah, absolutely. And are you in contact with other groups right around the country? Because in your area, of course, it's a renewable energy zone, but there are battles along the coastlines and inland in most states these days.
We are talking to groups all over the place, Chris. I mean, it's incredible how many people this is upsetting and impacting. It's huge. 10,000 kilometres of power lines in New South Wales alone, and the devastation it's doing to the countryside and to rural businesses is off the charts. I mean, there's now a commission or an inquiry into this, and hopefully some good comes of it, because really we've been forgotten about out in the bush. And while we do, happy to produce most of the food and fibre for this country, it seems at times like this, we're also being asked to cop the bill for everyone's rush into renewables.
Yeah, well, we haven't forgotten about these issues on this program. We'll keep on them, Tim. So thanks for talking to us. We'll keep in touch.
Really appreciate it, Chris. Thanks for your help, mate.